Morning, VC. This is Dave, and so this morning I saw a video from Dom over at Seeking a Thread, and he's doing a contest, and I definitely dig this idea, and this is, you know, kind of a celebration of his 300th episode on the radio there in Ithaca, for his Searching for a Thread show. And on also kind of earmark him passing 500 subs, or he's almost to 600 now, probably, something along those lines. But he wants us to show at least 5 records or tapes or whatever, CDs related to golden songs, or I guess songs that are important to you in one way or another. I got a bunch of stuff I just immediately pulled out that came right to top of mind. So there wasn't a whole lot of planning in this, but I literally had to break out my cassette case out of the closet and my guitar from behind the bed. So this ought to be interesting. So I guess the first thing I might as well show will be my original cassette of Rush Moving Pictures on Polygram Records. I got this as soon as I heard it. And you know, this is what got me into rock and roll right here. Hearing this for the first time. I've told the story before in the hedgerow with my friend when we were, you know, we should have been murdered to death by his mom if she, you know, because we weren't listening to country. So yeah, of course, you know, you play it in a cassette player, you start right off. So Tom Sawyer, and that blew my mind. But then Red Barjetta was like, okay, yeah, Red Barjetta was my favorite song on this, and that's the reason I do what I do. It all started here. So, and you know, we lost Neil Peart recently, which was still hard to come to terms with. But I did get to see them on a tour, Arrows tour. Forget the name. So I was very fortunate to see them at least, well, once. Took many years, but I did. The next important song for me, college, Fredonia State in New York, my friend Jake. Yeah, and it's funny, Jake isn't, he now lives in Jersey. He went to school for engineering, and he worked on the first Mars rover. Yeah, in some capacity, with some part of it, like an actual engineering, some part that went on it or something. But yeah, he introduced me to this band and to this record. Helmet, strap it on, and this is my original CD, and the song FBLA was the one for me on this, and this got me into the whole New York hardcore scene at the time, and I have since picked up an original on vinyl. So this is an original on Amphetamine Reptile. Oh, hell, and I didn't even remember what year this is from. This is from 1990. So I was a little late to the party, because I don't think he introduced me to these guys till 92. But yeah, and I've now seen Helmet 3 or 4 times. Yeah, and so, Paige Hamilton's now got these guys from Australia with him. He ended up moving from New York City out to Los Angeles, so he's now LA-based. But I've got an autographed poster from them. I've met, shook his hand. So, yeah, Helmet, huge. Got me into that whole New York thing, and then this band came along. And so, all right. So you get to see my one and only child. Yeah, see if I can even get this in the shot, but So that is the breakdown of Dine Alone, song from, and I have my original CD, Quicksand, and the album Slip. I heard this and I was floored. Walter Schreifels is a fucking genius. And I actually got to see him and his band Rival Schools open for Thursday when Thursday blew up, that band here in the Casbah at Tremont. And I also got to shake Walter Schreifels' hand when he walked off stage. That's a highlight of my musical journeys. And I have since picked up the 20th anniversary press of Slip. This is a nice record. Only 1,000 were pressed. I'd love to have an original, but I don't. I got this at the old lunchbox, so I've had this forever. But yeah, and so that leads me to the next band, which is gonna be what I have a sticker of on my guitar. And that is Local H. And the reason why this guitar is what it is, so this is an 88 Gibson SG Standard 1, as you see there on the headstock. This was, I had at the old Reliable Music, custom put together, had everything torn out and then redone. So you have a Seymour Duncan bass pickup here. You have a DiMarzio Evolution here. You got a three-way switch here. You got two jacks, so see that, two jacks. And you got a tone and two volumes. So I can plug into two rigs at the same time, a bass and a guitar rig similar to Scott Lucas from Local H. And I met him after a show and asked him how he had his whole setup, and he told me, and so immediately afterwards I went and had this built. And it also had to do with the fact that I was playing in a band called Jarvis at the time. And we had a bass player who would never show up to practice, so we kicked him out of the band, and I was like, well, we need to get some low end. So I did this with this guitar so it would get more low end, and it's tuned to drop C, and these are D'Addario 12s, so big heavy strings. And so yeah, that's why you get that kind of more of a bass end out of that guitar. That guitar is a bastard to keep in tune, I can tell you that. But yeah, so Local H, the song for me would have been High Five and Motherfucker. And this is the original promo cassette. And on the back it says, yeah, mom, the F word is in this song. And hearing this freaking course, there was a song on this album that came out that was all over the radio. As Good as Dead, I've since picked up the anniversary vinyl of this. Bound for the Floor, which was the big hit. But I got to see these guys at Tremont in the main room in different incarnations with different drummers over the years. Scott Lucas was cool enough to tell me his whole secrets on his rig. And so I've since done that. But that song, that High Five and Motherfucker song, that's the shit. Also taking a step back in college, I'll show you this. This is also on the guitar. So on the back, as you can see there. I'm a big guitar guy. Kim Thayil is one of my gods. And here is my original Bad Motorfinger cassette and Rusty Cage. Outshine was the first hit. I thought that was pretty good, but when I heard Rusty Cage, I was sold, and of course went backwards in their catalog after this. But this is the original cassette on A&M. And I also have my original CD. I don't have vinyl, but I do have the original CD, and this is the Psalms. So this has the extra tracks with Into the Void, Girl You Want, Stray Cat Blues, She's a Politician, and Slaves and Bulldozers Live. And I found this in a used CD store here just randomly for like $5. And this is like worth $100 or something. But yeah, Soundgarden was my number one of the whole grunge scene, still is. I did get to see them open for Nine Inch Nails. So, yeah. Before, you know, goddamn. Another major loss with Chris Cornell. God damn it. Just a couple more here. Do I have the CD of this? I think I have the CD of this too, but now, anyway, I remember hearing this for the first time, this band, and you'll notice by the Trail of Dead, and as it turns out, every album opens with some kind of epic, killer driving song, and this album right here, Source Tags and Codes, the beginning, and It Was There That I Saw You. This is this band and this album blew my mind when I first heard this when it came out, and has since gone to see them multiple times up in Carrboro at Cat's Cradle, and then the one time at Cat's Cradle, I was like first second row up with my friend Joe, and these guys party like insane. They brought the first two rows of people up on stage with them. They had double drums going on. I'm standing in between the two drummers, just jumping up and down. Everybody's having a blast. They're throwing down. And the roadie's sitting there behind the two drummers looking at me, ready to kill me if I took anything. And then after the gig, we're just shooting the shit with the guys, and they invited us out to go get drunk with them. We couldn't go. We had to go back to Charlotte because we had to work the next morning. It's like 2.5 hour drive, 2 hour drive. This Trail of Dead, some more major shit. And then last but not least, went to a gig up in Raleigh to see this band Medications out of DC, Discord label, phenomenal. Mr. Ocampo, Devin Ocampo, fucking guitar genius. And this band from Athens opened up. Desark also was there to open, and she's fucking amazing musician out of Greensboro. But Cinemechanica went on second. We never heard of them. And they were touring this album at the time, The Martial Arts. And these are limited to 1,000. I have number 177, I believe, here. Phenomenal artwork. So that's the original album, but I first, of course, had the CD and the song, I'm Tired of Paul McCartney. Yeah. It's just great math rock out of Athens, and this started a whole journey for me with filming this band and getting into the Athens scene and filming other bands from Athens, and yeah, just opened a whole nother world of music, during that time period. And I forget what year, because I'm getting old and now time starts to run together. But that's it. I want to thank Dom for doing this, because I mean, I hadn't busted out that guitar in forever, and hell, I had to even find my glow-in-the-dark alien pick buried in my wallet. But that's my contest entry. Peace.